Good morning, students. Today we are going to start our sixth chapter from our prime English book, which is a poem named The Coming of Spring. Students, this is a poem by an unknown poet, as the name of the poet is not mentioned in this book, so we are calling it anonymous, means someone or somebody. So here, as you know, that the poet is not mentioned, so we are calling it anonymous. This poem is about the beauty of spring season. The poet shows many ways that how the nature welcomes the spring season. When spring enters, then every creature looks cheerful and happy, as like in a way that they are spreading the message that spring has arrived and everything starts looking beautiful. So here in the poem, students, first I am going to read this poem and after that I will explain this poem stanza-wise. The coming of spring. Oh, the sunshine told the bluebirds, and the bluebirds told the brook, that the dandelion were peeping from the woodland shelter nook. Then the brook was blithe and happy, and it babbled all the way, as it ran to tell the river of the coming of glorious May. Soon the river told the meadow, and the meadow told the bee, that the tender buds are swelling on the old chestnut tree. And the bee shook off its leaf and spread each yellow wing as it flew to tell the flowers of the coming of spring. So, this was the poem, students. Now, I am going to explain this poem stanza-wise. So, first stanza I am taking from here to here. Oh, the sunshine told the bluebirds, and the bluebirds told the brook, that the dandelion were peeping from the woodland's shelter nook. So in the first stanza, the first two lines, oh, the sunshine told the bluebirds, and the bluebirds told the brook. Now here, what is happening? This was the stanza, and now I am going to explain the poem stanza-wise. Okay, so here, as you can see, the rays of sun are telling the bluebirds. Bluebird is a type of bird which is of blue color. So, rays of the sun are telling the bluebirds, and the bluebird is telling the brook. Now, what do you mean by brook? Brook here is a small stream, is a narrow stream of water which is going to meet the river at the last. Okay. So that the dandelion are peeping from the woodland shelter nook. Now what is happening here? As you can see, dandelion is a yellow type of flower. It's more like a daisies. It's daisies. Okay, so it is peeping. What do you mean by peeping? Looking secretly. Okay, and it is looking secretly from the woodland. So woodland here means dense forest. Okay, and shelter means shed. Nook means corner. So here we can say that the dandelions are looking secretly from the dense forest corner. Okay. So here what happens that the sunshine told the bluebirds and the bluebirds told the brook that the dandelions are peeping from the woodland shelter nook. Now the next paragraph, then the brook was blithe and happy. It babbled all the way as it ran to tell the river of the coming of glorious May. Then the brook was blithe and happy, and it babbled all the way. So it means that when the brook heard this message, remember, what do you mean by brook? Brook means narrow stream of water. So it heard the message. It became cheerful. It became happy. So it started babbling. What do you babble means? Babble means to talk rapidly and continuously in foolish or exciting way. So here the brook got so happy that it start babbling. Okay, in excited way it start babbling, and what happens? And then he ran towards the river. It ran towards the river as it ran to tell the river of the coming of glorious May. So the brook ran towards the river to tell that glorious May has arrived. And glorious means here popular, famous. Okay. So, what is happening here? So, sunshine first went to bluebird and bluebird went to brook. Now, brook got so excited, said, it started babbling to the and it ran towards the river. Soon the river told the meadow and the meadow told the bee that the tender buds were swelling on the old chestnut tree. Okay, so now soon the river told the meadow and the meadow told the bee. Now when the river heard this news, it ran to tell the meadows. Okay, meadow means grass fields. Okay, especially used for hay, where the animal graze. Okay, where the grazing of animal is done. So that is the place of meadow. So this river is going to tell the grass fields, and the grass field heard the news that May has come. This exciting May has come, and the grass field told the bee. Now the next person has received, next living creature has got the news that May has arrived. So that the tender buds were swelling on the old chestnut tree. So here it is telling that meadow told the bee that the tender buds, here tender means soft buds, okay, and that the swelling, here swelling means that the bud has come out. So soft bud has started coming out on the old chestnut tree. What is chestnut here? Chestnut is a glossy, hard, brown, edible nut. Okay, it is a dry fruit. And the next paragraph is, and the bee shook off the sleep and spread each yellow wing as it flew to tell the flower of the coming of spring. So, and the bee shook off the sleep and spread each yellow wing. So, now the bee was sleeping. Bee's sleep got over. It started moving its yellow wings. Okay, shook means to shake off, to get rid of sleep. So now the bee broke off its sleep and started flying to tell the yellow flower that May has already arrived and spring has arrived. Okay, so now all the message, all the living creatures are very happy and they are telling each other that the spring has finally arrived. And they, all living creatures, are very cheerful, very happy. So it means that it shows that how happy the nature is when the spring has arrived. So when the May arrives, it means that spring has already arrived. So the message is delivered from different creatures to each and everything, and they are just happy. They are just happy, and they are showing, nature is showing what changes come. What changes come here. So now we are going to discuss about the summary. Summary is short explanation of this poem. This is a short poem in which the poet describes the beauty of spring season. He is telling that how plants and animals are telling everyone that spring is round the corner. The poet had used beautiful words to explain that the importance of spring season in every living being's life. The sun, the bluebird, the streams, the river, the grass fields, the bees, the flowers all became very happy by the coming of the spring. So I hope that you have liked this poem, students. So now we are going to discuss about the difficult words here. Okay, and I have given you to write the difficult words and word meanings in the notebook. And you should understand. I hope that you people enjoy spring season. So difficult words here is, first one, bluebird, brook, dandelion, peeping, woodland, sheltered, bleed, babbled, glorious, meadow, swelling, chestnut. So that's it for today's class. Thank you everyone. Have a good day.